स्टेनो वाले बाबू वेलकम्स यू। शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस इन मेल एंड फीमेल वॉइस फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेस लाइक मैगजीन्स, स्पीचेस एंड एडिटोरियल्स एट वेरियस स्पीड्स अप टू 120 WPM फॉर वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स लाइक SSC, DSSB, CRPF, दिल्ली पुलिस एक्सेट्रा। प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। थैंक यू। एक्सरसाइज नंबर 16। सर, द बेसिस ऑफ द बिल हैज ऑल्सो बीन क्वेश्चन्ड, दैट इज वेदर द रीस्ट्रक्चरिंग ऑफ द कैपिटल ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशंस इज एट ऑल नीडेड। इट इज आवर व्यू that a developmental agency should be organizationally independent and its board professionalized, having fully fed the Industrial Development Bank of India since its infancy for a decade, the Reserve Bank has placed it in a position of importance. The government have therefore taken the view that the time has arrived to elevate the status of the Development Bank to that of the principal financial institution. Just as the Reserve Bank is the central bank of the country, the Life Insurance Corporation of India is the principal investment institution. The Development Bank should achieve the status of the principal financial institution. All the three being directly owned by the government, the bill seeks to achieve this purpose. Further, the board of the principal financial institution should reflect the various impulses of different states of India, particularly those which are industrially backward. As I have already explained, you will see from clause 6 of the bill that in a board of 23 members, excepting two who are government officials and two employees of the financial institutions, the rest are professionals in the sense that they represent all India and state level financial institutions, banks and various fields like science, technology, industry, economics, industrial, cooperative, marketing, etc. The Reserve Bank as the central bank of the country will be represented at the level of a deputy governor on the board and on the executive committee of the Development Bank. The Reserve Bank is therefore in a position to continue to make its positive contribution to the operation of the Development Bank and through it all the other financial institutions. It has also been argued that after the restructuring of the Development Bank, neither the volume of credit to industry will increase nor will be the cost of credit decrease, and thus there is no economic rationales for the bill. In any event, the mobilization of resources and their channeling will be done in close coordination with the Reserve Bank. Having elevated the status of the IDBI and made it statutorily responsible for the coordination, the Development Bank and the other financial institutions will work with greater cohesion and to that extent, there will be better development of resources all round. A point has also been raised that with the transfer of the shareholding of the Industrial Development Bank of India from the Reserve Bank to the government, large industrial group would have easier access to institutional finance than before. In the second note of dissent by my honorable friends, similar point has been made about the credit policies to be followed by the IDBI loans have not been defined. The policy of financing industry, including small scale industry, cooperatives, etc., and the large industrial groups is determined by government for implementing the policy of government. It is perhaps not very material whether the Industrial Development Bank of India is directly owned by government or owned through the Reserve Bank. Parliament has been, therefore, the opportunity to oversee the policy being followed by the Development Bank and the other institutions in financing industry in general and the larger industrial groups in particular. The honorable member have in their minute of dissent referred to the position that the employees representatives will not be elected on the board but will be selected in a manner prescribed by government. They have referred to the practice prevailing in regard to the appointment of directors on the boards of the nationalized banks. I may inform the House that in the case of the nationalized banks, the scheme framed under the Banking Nationalization Act does not provide as such for a direct election by workmen or their representatives on the boards of the banks, and a representative is chosen out of a panel of three names suggested by the Federation, which on verification by the Central Labour Commissioner has the largest number of workmen as members. A more or less similar procedure will be drawn up in this case also for selection of the employees' representatives. I now take this opportunity of paying a tribute to the services rendered by the Reserve Bank of India in feeding the Industrial Development Bank of India from its infancy and having brought it up to its present status so that it could take up the leadership of the other financial institutions independently. As I have already stated earlier, the Industrial Development Bank of India will continue to be as much a concern of the Reserve Bank as of the government in the new setup as well. I have every hope that the Development Bank, as the principal financial institution in the field of industrial finance, with its enlarged role, should be able to play an effective part in the balanced industrial development of the country in accordance with national priority and aspiration. This has been provided in the preamble by the Joint Committee constituted for the debt purpose. Thank you.